We will talk in this video about variable logging using the Snooper Trace. The Trace32 debugger provides the possibility to log variable chains while the program execution is running by using the so-called Snooper feature. This does not require any extra trace capability. This tutorial will show you how to use this Trace32 feature. The basis for the variable logging is the so-called runtime memory access. The runtime memory access allows the debugger to read memory while the program execution is running, with nearly no impact on the program execution. The variable log is stored with the timestamp information into a buffer allocated by Trace32 on the Trace32 debug module. This tutorial is presented with the Trace32 release version of September 2017 using Trace32 PowerView for TriCore and a PowerDebug Pro connected to a Tri board with a TC275T. So let's start with the configuration of the Snooper. Since the Snooper is part of the Trace32 Trace framework, you have to open the Trace configuration window by selecting the Trace from the Trace32 menu bar, then Configuration. Select Snooper as Trace method. The default logging mode for the Snooper is memory. This mode enables the Snooper to read the logging information from any address in the physical memory. The Select field allows you to enter the address or even more conveniently the variable. With the help of the Select button, the name of the variable to be logged can be selected from the sample database. We will select, for instance, the variable plot1. Now let's start the program execution. The progress bar and the counter indicates the number of logged variable values. Let's look to the results by hitting the list button. The window displays the address of the logged variable together with the logged data value, the variable's name, as well as the time between the logs. The Snooper list command can also be colored with different parameters. The command Snooper list var timebug allows, for instance, an even more compact representation of the logging results. The time between the logs is about 56 microseconds in average. This time is determined by the debug protocol and the JTAG log, and is essential for the logging. Because logging a variable with the help of the Snooper only makes sense if the variable changes at a higher rate than the average logging period. Please be aware that even the average logging period cannot be guaranteed, because the software running on the Trace32 debug module might be busy doing some other tasks. So single times between two logs can be even bigger. The max field in the Snooper configuration window displays the maximum time between two logs. By sampling the variable plot2, we can see that several consecutive logs show the same variable value. Using the mode change, a new log is only added to the Snooper buffer if it contains a new variable value. As you can see now, consecutive logs have always different values. By hitting the draw button, the logged variable values are displayed graphically. By adding the option track to the Snooper list and the Snooper draw windows, both windows will be time synchronized. After clicking in the Snooper window, the other window will automatically follow the focus. Using the Snooper, it is possible to log up to 16 variables. To select more than one variable, click the Select button. The Snooper Select dialog will pop up. Click then this button to get a list of all variables. Select the first variable, then hit OK. Repeat the same procedure and select the second variable, then hit Add. Let's start the program execution and then stop it after a few seconds. The snooper list window now displays the logs for both variables. It's important to know that the variables are read one after the other. The time between the logs increases when sampling multiple variables. To find the time between two samples for one variable, click the Find button, then enter plot1 under address expression and click Find All. We can see that the time is now about 110 microseconds on average. We can use the command snooper drawer to display both variables graphically. The color legend is displayed in the upper part of the window. Displaying both variables in the same graph doesn't always make sense, especially if they have very different value range. In this case, it makes more sense to display each variable in a separate window and use the zoom track option to get both the time and the zoom factor synchronization. When clicking in one window, the other window will follow the focus. To summarize, Trace32 can log up to 16 different variables. Variable logging can also be done if the debugger has no real-time access to the memory or if caches and MMUs are used. In this case, the program execution is shortly interrupted to read the specified memory locations. Trace32 also allows you to log other objects in your embedded system, example the program counter, or performance counters that count, example, the data cache miss rate. Are you interested? Find more information in the snooper application note. Thank you and see you in the next video.